start today. The poem Voice of the Rain by Walt Whitman. As the name of the poem suggests, it's on rain. Okay, the poet Walt Whitman is asking the rain. That means here in the poem we have only conversation of two people, the poet and the rain. The poet is asking the questions and the rain is answering. And who art thou, said I to the soft falling shower, which, strange to tell, give me an answer as here translated. I am the poem of the earth, said the voice of the rain. And who art thou? Thou means you. The poet is asking the question to the rain, that the soft falling rain, that who are you? The answer, which strange to tell, give me an answer as here translated, means the rain is answering the question that is asked by the poet. The rain is answering that it is strange to express, but it is explained by the rain, and the rain replies that I am the poem of the earth. I am the poem of the earth, said the voice of rain. The voice of rain, the rain is answering the question that is asked by the poet. Eternal I rise, impalpable out of the land and the bottomless sea, upward to heaven, whence vaguely formed altogether, changed and yet the same. Eternal I rise, impalpable. Impalpable means untouched. Okay, I rise from such a place which is, or from the place which is untouched. Okay, the rain says that the poem of the earth is invisible and is untouched, and I am from the place which is untouched by anyone. That is, no one can touch me from the bottomless sea, where I cannot be seen or I cannot be touched. Upward to heaven, whence? Whence means the source from where I am coming. I come from heaven. My source is from heaven. Vaguely formed, altogether changed. Vaguely means roughly, in a very high speed. Okay, altogether changed and yet the same. Means I come from heaven, I come from sky, I have different appearances. My appearance is of a cloud. Okay, clouds. I appear as if I come from clouds. I have different shape and different size, but I come from a place which is remained untouched and which no one has seen yet, but I remain safe. I am there in everyone's heart. That means I come from heaven. I have different shapes, different sizes. I have a shape. Shape is of a cloud. But still, I come. Where I come from, nobody knows. I descend to lave the draughts, atomies, dust layers of the globe. Descend. Descend means downwards. From up, I come down, I fall, to lave the draughts. Lave the draughts is to wash away the draughts. Kyunki mere aane se pehle summer season tha. Or summer season, the earth is dry. Okay? It doesn't have any green. You cannot see any greenery. But when I come, I wash away all the draughts. Draughts means scarcity of water. Jahan par bhi scarcity hai, I wash away all that and I fill water in that. Atomies, dust layers of the globe. Atomies are small particles, and dust layers of globe means all the particles, all the dust that is there on the layer, I wash away everything and I fill the earth, I fill the planet with greenery. And all that in them without me were seeds only, latent, unborn. Latent means hidden. And without me, all the seeds that are there under the earth, below the earth's crust, would never come out. It's I who bring them out. I who give them birth. Otherwise, they would remain unborn. They would be remaining inside the earth, hidden. Nobody could see any plants, any seeds coming out. It's me. It's the rain that brings the seeds out or give birth to the seeds. And forever by day and night, I give back life to my own origin. For day and night I come on the earth with great speed, with full vigor, and I give life to origin, because without me, without water, they all were like non-living. I give them life. I bring them back to life, and then they start to grow. The plants, the seeds, the trees full of greenery, the animals, the birds, people, everyone becomes lively because of me and make pure and beautified. I beautify the nature. The rain beautify the nature, because summer season everything turns up dry and it's me who makes it green. For song issuing from its birthplace after fulfillment, wandering, wrecked or unwrecked, duly with love returns. The poet feels that the rain is a kind of a song. It's singing, and the birthplace of the song is in poet's heart. Actually, the rain is not answering. The question is asked by the poet, but do you think rain is answering? No, it's the poet's heart that is answering, and the poet feels that the answer is given from poet's heart. Once it is completed, once it is done, from one person that I have heard, I feel that the answer is given by the rain. I am passing it to you people. Now you read and you will also feel that the rain is answering. That means I have felt, now you will feel, and the listeners will feel that the rain has answered. The last line of the poem, it's in bracket. For song issuing from its birthplace after fulfillment, wandering, wrecked or unwrecked, duly with love returns. Wrecked or unwrecked, whether I am important or not, the rain is telling whether I am important or not. But still, it's, you know, when you end up with the letter and you write, you're loving, you're truly and all. So same way here the poet has told that the conversation between the rain and the poet is ending here with love. Duly with love is written by the rain. That means the rain has answered all the questions that the poet has asked. And the conversation here, the last lines of the poem, which are kept in the bracket, they do not belong to the conversation between the poet and the rain. Last line, which is kept in the bracket, before that the conversation took place. But then the last line, you know, with love returns, it's as if the rain has answered or rain has written with love. But that part is not the conversation, that is the poet that is writing about the rain. That I thank you, or with love, that you come and you give a new life to the entire living organisms, entire living things. So that is why the last part of the poem, which is kept in the bracket, it is only poet's thought. Before that, he feels that the rain has answered all the questions, and here he is actually thanking the rain for giving a new life to everything on the earth, because without rain, nothing would be lively. Hope you understood the poem.